Hi, I'm Jeff, and I'm here today to help walk you through this intermediate GMAT problem. Go ahead and take a couple minutes on your own to solve it. Whenever I see a problem involving rates, I always want to keep in mind this equation. Rate times time equals work done. And it helps sometimes to just plug in some values to familiarize yourself with this equation. So for example, if I read a book at 15 pages per hour, and I read for 3 hours, I should finish reading 45 pages after 3 hours. Okay. So familiarize yourself with this equation. It is going to be a major help on all rate problems. The other thing we want to keep in mind on a problem involving multiple machines working or multiple people helping to do a job is we want to create a rate chart to help kind of keep track of all these moving pieces. So the first thing I'm going to fill out in my rate chart is information about this 12 identical machine scenario. I'll just call that 12M. And what I know about these 12 machines is they take 8 days to complete a shipment. So I'll go ahead and write 8 days for the 12 machines time, and the work they do is one shipment. So from this, I can deduce now that the rate of these 12 machines is 1/8, because 1/8 multiplies by 8 to equal 1. In real world terms, what this means is these 12 machines complete 1/8 of the shipment every day. Now, what I'm going to have to do here is figure out how many machines it's going to take to do this whole job of one shipment in 6 days. Well, I know to get the shipment done in 6 days, I have to work faster, right? So we know we're gonna need more machines. How much faster are we gonna have to work? Well, something times 6 days equals one shipment. We can now solve that the rate of all of these machines will need to be 1/6, right? 1/6 of the shipment is done each day. Okay. Now, the hidden step to these rate problems is going to be to solve the rate for a single machine, okay? A single machine will work slower than 12 machines. Logically, that makes sense. But one way we want to think about this is in terms of scale. 12 machines have a rate of 1/8. 6 machines, so half the number of machines, should have a rate of 1/2 of an 1/8, or 1/16. Basically, whenever we scale up or scale down the number of machines, we are going to scale up or down the rate of those machines as well. So when we go from 12 machines down to 1 machine, we are going to cut our rate into 1/12 of its original rate. So the rate of 12 machines was 1/8. 1 machine works 12 times slower than 12 machines. So 1/8 divided by 12 will give us our rate of a single machine. 1/8 divided by 12 is the same as 1/8 times 1/12, which is 1/96. Similarly, how we scale down here, we are going to have to scale up. 1 machine does 1/96 of the shipment each day, and I need now to do 1/6 of the shipment each day. So I need to determine what my scale up factor will be. So I need to go from 1/96, multiply it by X machines now to get to the new rate of 1/6, right? And we can kind of test this out again, right? If one machine's rate is 1/96, then two machines' rate would be 2/96. And three machines' rate would be 3/96. I need to figure out how many machines do a rate of 1/6. So I will solve for x here, multiplying both sides by 96. What this turns into is 96 divided by 6, and 96 divided by 6 is 16. So x here will actually be 16 machines, and that represents an increase of 4 machines from where we started. How many additional machines will we need? We'll need 4 additional machines. So a couple of key takeaways on problems like this. First, anytime you have a rate problem, we want to remember our equation, rate times time equals work done. Whenever you have a problem involving multiple machines working, create a rate chart. Really, really helpful for organizing all these kind of moving parts. And then the key step here, in my opinion, is to not solve straight away for the additional machines, but to use this intermediate step and go find the rate of a single machine. Subscribe for more GMAT Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep, and leave us a comment below telling us how you solved this problem. Happy studying.